Hello, and welcome to Assassin's Creed Unity.
The past is not lost. The past lives inside us. Encoded in the double helix are the experiences of our ancestors. After three decades of research, our engineers have forged the cutting edge of biotechnological interfaces. We have unlocked the lives of our forebears. We have opened a window into the past. This is Total Immersion Entertainment.
No, it's Abstergo. Don't lie to me.
You will experience the most pivotal moments in history. All from the comfort of home. Welcome to Helix.
Abstergo.
Where the past is your playground.
The past is your playground. So yeah, Abstergo are back. Obviously. Of course they're back. I liked that TV advert. I would go for it if I wasn't aware of what was going on. Oh Lord. So there's all these things. I don't know what these are. Oh, they're all locked. Oh. Is that Aveline? The devils are the cat. Fear and loathing in. I like this. That's interesting. That's Altair. That's Connor. That's Aveline. That. I'm not sure about. I don't know about that dude either. He looks a bit Roman in origin. That's Edward. That's Ezio. That's. I assume that's Haytham from the Lone Eagle and then also the Tricorn Hat. Don't know who this guy is. He looks evil though. Borgias. There's a TV series on them. So this looks like different chapters, I guess, of the game. Jacques de Molay, who knows? I've no idea how this works. This looks quite cool, though. So I guess without further ado, let's do this.
Last of the heroic Knights Templar, Jacques de Molay was a man of principle, a towering intellect, betrayed by those he trusted. In this episode of Fallen Heroes, experience Jacques de Molay's final tragic hours through the eyes of one of his closest friends and advisors.
Oh, I see. So, this is obviously set up like it would be. I like this. I really like this interface. So they are setting it up as an actual playable interface if you were a person in Abstergo land. I still love to think that actually Ubisoft are Abstergo and it's all hilariously corrupt and somewhere underneath Ubisoft are going to take over the world via the Apple of Eden existing. That would be on one hand hilariously cool and on the other hand very, very worrying. So, I don't know. But, okay. So, the last of the heroic Knights Templar, Jacques de Molay, was a man of principle, a towering intellect betrayed by the man he trusted most, the corrupt King of France. So, this is where, like, the revolution is probably going to come from here. So, let's play. I'll put subtitles on ASAP. Now, I am playing this on the Xbox One currently because I've got a review copy. But I will be switching to PC for co-op and when I get a PC code. So you guys know that, that's just clarified. Paris, France, the 13th of October, 1307. So this is well before the revolution. This is back in the medieval times, the dark ages.
Who goes there?
A friend of the temple.
Floirac, the council's message was absolute. You're not welcome here.
I must speak with the Grand Master.
He's in session, they all are. Another day, perhaps.
King Philip disagrees.
Damn you, man.
Damn you, man. Damn you!
Why you're not rotting in a cell at this moment, I cannot fathom.
Well, he's dead. Oh, income. Oh, I see. Is the king taking over? Is this why the Templars were massacred? We know they disappear from history, but we didn't quite know why. This is the dude.
We are betrayed. Draw a swordsmen! Defend the temple!
Not you, brother. I have a different task for you. Come with me.
Are you running away, you big cowardly bum? Oh, this is me. Yay! Right, hang on, Jacques. Hang on, un moment, s'il vous plaît. I would like to put on the... Oh, yes. No. Rift guide? Oh. Oh, yes, no. No, where is it? It must be probably on the sound. Yes, there it is. I would like the subtitles on, please. Thank you. HUD. Let's just see what we can do. Ah, so many things we can turn on and off as we wish. I like this. Puppeteer, what? I like it very much. Right, okay.
It's moving faster than we expected.
Another hand is at work here.
The Pope
and the Assassins.
Assassins? I thought the Mongol Khans broke their power decades ago.
The Assassins are far older than us. We will not prevail this night, but if you make haste, we may yet save our order.
What must I do?
Go to the tower. Take the sword and the book. Hide them. They must not fall into the assassin's hands.
Grandmaster, I will.
Oh, God. So I'm helping save the Templars from... Oh, hello. Ah! Let's just... Yeah, let's go in here and attack. Sure. I mean, we'll just happily massacre a load of people. Get out of here. Shoo! No, we run. Can we run? Yes, there we go.
Hold the bridge, hold! Down, have to take a different way.
Well, climb, you bugger. You're designed for this. Well, actually, you might not be, but... Come on, there we go. Through a window. And I guess through this door? No, I guess we're going out the window again. Oh dear, that was a close one. So free run up. I'm just guesstimating here. But I assume we go up to go down. Oh yes. There's a dead body there. So B to drop, yeah. Oh God. Oh no, I know what the smoke means. Okay. The archers. I'm coming down the stairs. Interesting fact about these. Do you know why they're circular? Do you know why they go this way down? It's because you, if you're fighting in a tower and you're defending, you're going to go up and up and up. So you want to have, if you're right-handed, you are getting an advantage by being able to swing downwards. If you're right-handed coming up, I know this is like a very important time to save the Templars, but if you're coming up, you're going to swing and hit the outer wall. It could be absolute bollocks, but that's what the guys at Warwick Castle reckon is a thing.
The tower! They've breached the tower! They've taken the...
Oh, bloody hell! Come back here! What are you jogging for? Come on! Where's he gone? Oh, God. Oh, he's there. Oh, you cheeky shit. Right, come here. I'm gonna get you. I'm gonna bloody get you. And when I do, I'm gonna end you. Yeah? I'm gonna bloody get you. Come here. I didn't really want to draw my weapon. Oh God. Ooh! Oh, ooh, Lord. That's definitely an assassin. Oh! Just stab it. Whoa! He's got cutlass. Cheeky bugger. Well, a curved sword, not necessarily a cutlass. I'm not parrying him, I'm just going to kill him. Oh no, maybe I should have done. Oh God, he's blinded me. Come back here. Come here. No, come on, run. Templars, not good. This guy is far superior to me. Oh, you cheeky shit. Right. Oh. There we go. Thank you. Cool. The parrying system is slightly new. You've got to be a little bit, like, there's less of a prompt, which I quite like, but it is also a bit of a, what? Is that, what the dickens is that sword? What? Why couldn't we have done that before? That is a stupid sword. I don't know where you got that, but it's obviously, like, Apple age, I guess. Apple of Eden age. It's the equivalent of a lightsaber, isn't it? Just like blast you with energy.
What the devil is this place?
Important books have been put in a magical vault. And some cherubim. Oh, the sword goes in the... Oh. The cherubim hold the magical shiny sword. Oh shit, maybe this is Excalibur. Maybe this is what the legend of Excalibur is based on in this mythos, in the Assassin's Creed mythos, not in the real world mythos. Interesting. Ooh. Oh shit. Well, GG, no re. It's gone. How are you gonna get in there? I don't think you are. I don't think you're gonna get in there, mate. You ain't a Templar. You don't know about the penitent man kneeling and all that. Oh, 7 years later. Oh, we're doing a burning. Witches? Are they witches? Or are they just... Oh, no, they're just Templars.
Pope Clement, hear me? Before this year is out, you will answer for your crimes before God Almighty. And you, King Philip... No punishment is too heinous for the great evil you have inflicted upon the temple. I curse you! Curse you to the 13th generation of your blood! You shall be cursed!
Oh dear.
Consumed in flames of hunger and wrath, thus came the age of true wisdom to a blistering close. The Knights Templar, once the proud shepherds of order, peace, and illumination, were no more.
So we thought. Ha 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 ha!
Yeah, let's get a sniffer running. If Abstergo pings us, pull me out.
Hello?
Okay. I have a visual. Hey there. This is probably disorienting, so I'll be brief. I'm Bishop, not my real name, obviously, but that's as much as you'll get today. Please listen carefully. Abstergo is using you, hijacking your neurons to help them sift through genetic memory data. These guys already have their fingers in countless corporations, governments, media outlets, and NGOs. But now, they want control over history itself. If that doesn't frighten you, it should. But we're here to stop them, and I need your help. Deacon, preload gene sequence AD16, B13, I87.
What's going on?
Last week, we gained access to a bank of unsequenced memories in Abstergo's Helix servers. For now, we'd like you to experience a small sample. This should help you understand our struggle. And after that, you can decide for yourself what comes next. We'll be waiting.
Oh, okay. I mean, if I was a player at home, I'd be like, this is part of the gaming experience. Arguably it is, isn't it? Oh, man. I recognise her voice and face. I'll put it on the screen if I can find out who she is. On day of release, I probably won't be able to, but I thought it was Ashley Johnson again, as in Ellie, but I'm not quite sure. There's a few actresses with very similar voices. Oh, this is France, Versailles, 27th of December, 1776. That's probably Arno then, the little kid.
Arno.
Oh, look, it is. Surprise! And that's his dad, who looks like he's an assassin. I think I saw a logo there, yeah, dangling. Thank you, Father.
Courage, my boy. You wait just here. I will return when this hand reaches the top.
Got 15 minutes then.
Not as long as all
15 minutes.
And when I get back, we'll see the fireworks. And Arno... No exploring,
Yes, Father.
You've just given him permission to explore. Don't tell children no. Like, don't state no something. Oh, that's a lot of busts. And that's a painting, I guess, of the current king. I'm not sure. Oh, I think that's probably Elise, my sister. She is dressed up like a panto dame in those colours. Good lord. Hello, Elise. Come back, please. Please. I have to walk after you. Oh, no, I can run.